ओम नमो भगवते नित्यानंदाय। तोंसे बाय, वंस भगवान नित्यानंदा वॉज प्लेइंग हैप्पीली विथ चिल्ड्रन इन द हाउस ऑफ ए दलित इन कापू नियर उडुपी। द पीपल इन द एरिया वेर वेरी मच फॉन्ड ऑफ नित्यानंद भगवान। वेन तोंसे सीताबाय केम टू दैट प्लेस इन सर्च ऑफ भगवान नित्यानंदा, ही गेव हर वॉटर फ्रॉम द हाउस ऑफ ए दलित एंड आस्क्ड हर टू ड्रिंक इट। She denied it just because it was from the house of a Dalit. She was practicing untouchability, practice of ostracizing a group by segregating them from the mainstream. Though she didn't tell the reason, Bhagwan understood and ordered her sternly to drink it, saying, "Water is the same in every house. Drink it. Stop this stupid practice." She immediately drank it. And from that day, she gave up the practice of untouchability. Blessing of Hubli Siddharuda Swamiji. The sister of Tonse Sitabai was an ardent devotee of Hubli Siddharuda Swami. She was residing in Hubli, that is in Karnataka. She did not like her sister Sitabai's devotion towards Bhagavan Nityananda. She insisted that Sitabai should go to Siddharuda Swamiji and only then would she stop following Nityananda Swamiji. Whenever Sitabai asked Bhagavan Nityananda's consent to go there, he questioned her, "Why?" Finally, one day he said, "Okay, go to Hubli, get the blessing of Siddharuda Swamiji." With Bhagavan's consent, she went to Hubli along with her sister. After the discourse by Siddharuda Swamiji, her sister approached Swamiji and offering pranams requested, "Swamiji, she is my sister Sitabai. Please bless her by initiating." Swamiji replied with a smile, "Amma, there is no need for that as she is already blessed immensely in Mangalore and is under the protection of a tremendous divine power." The younger sister realized that Siddharuda is not different from Nityananda. There is no difference between an Aruda and an Avaduta. It is believed that Bhagavan Nityananda and Siddharuda Swamiji had a conversation in secrecy in Hubli for 18 hours. By reading the book Swadhyaya Sudha by Muktananda Paramahamsa, one can get to know that the mantra Om Namah Shivaya and the name Muktananda were the blessings of Siddharuda Swamiji to Muktananda Swami, the former head of Gurudev Siddhapeeth. Protected the progeny of a woman in Uchila. When a woman in Uchila went to cut wood, Nityananda Swamiji squeezed her breast. All other women accompanying her got sacred and ran away. On getting to know this matter, people from the town came in the groups and were about to beat Bhagavan Nityananda. A few among the group noticed that a bluish-green liquid was dripping from the woman's breast. Pacifying the enraged crowd, Bhagavan Nityananda said, "Do not misunderstand my action. In this woman's breast, poisoned milk was getting formed. As a result, she has lost her 3 children. It won't happen hereafter. She will give birth to children who will become great devotees." Awk on the sea in Kapu. Youngsters who witnessed the miracles of Bhagavan Nityananda pleaded him to grant them sannyas diksha. However, their parents begged Bhagavan, saying, "Please do not make our children sannyasis. We are dependent on them and have nobody in this world except them." Bhagavan told the youngsters, "Have unshakable faith in God. Let your mind be pure. Serving your parents is as good as serving God." However, the youngsters were determined to become sannyasis and followed Bhagavan till Kapu beach. Bhagavan started walking fast on the sea and disappeared in a few seconds. Disappeared in front of Shivadas. Shivadas, the owner of a hotel, Chaitanya Vilas, situated on Old Kent Road in Mangalore, was an ardent devotee of Bhagavan Nityananda. Having obtained Brahma Diksha from the lineage of Shivananda Paramahamsa, Shivadas was naturally inclined to spirituality. He would often go to Pandava's cave in Kadri to have darshan of Bhagavan Nityananda. once right in front of Shivadas, Bhagwan dived into a lake in Kadri, never to come out from the same lake. Shivadas waited there thinking Bhagwan would emerge from the lake sooner or later. He kept on waiting for 3 days. Bhagwan never came there, but the news of his presence in Udupi and Gokarna reached Shivadas. Diksha to a boy. Raghavendra Swamiji of Malladalli village near Chitradurga was a great yoga sadhak. He has founded several educational institutions, written Ayurvedic books and served humanity by giving treatments to poor people for free. His childhood name was Raghu. When Raghu was a small boy, Bhagwan Nityananda had been to his home. The moment he entered the house, looking at young Raghu, he announced, "I will give you Diksha, initiation." Raghu, not knowing what Diksha is, innocently said, "Bhagwan, you can give me Diksha only if you give Diksha to my sister also. Not otherwise, not otherwise." Laughing at Raghu's innocence, Bhagwan left him, placing his hands on his head. By the grace of Bhagwan, he went on to become a great yoga practitioner by the name Raghavendra Swami. Having learned Ayurveda from Baba Lakshman Das, a versatile genius, an adept of both yoga and Ayurveda, and highly disciplined Ayurvedic practitioner, Raghavendra Swamiji succeeded on the path of yoga sadhana. Bhagwan slept on yarn. Bhagwan Nityananda was traveling in Kozhikode, earlier Calicut, and Kannur. A brother of Raghavan, a devotee in the area, was suffering from asthma. Since many years, Bhagwan ordered him to consume only rice soup. Following his advice, Raghavan's brother was completely cured of asthma. One day, Raghavan invited Bhagwan Nityananda to his house and made an arrangement for a comfortable bed on a cot for him to take rest. Refusing to sleep on the cot, Bhagwan asked for a ball of yarn and tied the thread from one window in the room to another window on the opposite side. When Raghavan woke up in the night, he was surprised to see that Bhagwan was comfortably lying on the thin yarn thread. He immediately wanted to show the incredible scene to his family members, but for some unknown reason, he just could not get up from his bed. Bhagwan Nityananda did not want to unnecessarily exhibit his power to others. Nityananda sat on the lap of Shivananda Paramahamsa. Pooja Shivananda Paramahamsa, the founder of Siddhashram in Badagara, Kerala, was giving a discourse on inner sadhana and meditation of Nirakara Tattva, formless Parabrahma. Speaking on the path of knowledge, Jnana Marga, he said, "Ravana didn't have 10 heads. They represented his 10 vices. The image of Ravana with 10 physical heads is an imagination." No sooner did he complete his sentence than some conservative people present in the hall, without understanding the essence of the words, picked stones to throw at him. They didn't like his interpretation. During his period, Bhagwan Nityananda was famous in the region with his childhood miracles. Suddenly, young Nityananda appeared in the discourse hall and sat on the lap of Shivananda Paramahamsa. There was a reason behind this action of Bhagwan Nityananda. Most of the people in the audience were his devotees. People who were about to throw stones were pacified and listened to the discourse till the end in a calm demeanor. Many people looking at the photographs of Bhagwan Nityananda and Shivananda Paramahamsa in the same frame misunderstand the former as a disciple of the latter. The reason behind this misconception is that in the photograph, Bhagwan Nityananda appears as a youth and Shivananda Paramahamsa appears much elder to him. Bhagwan Nityananda was born enlightened soul, Janma Siddha. When he was roaming in Avadhuta state, Shivanandaji was working as a police officer. The people in the area say that Shivanandaji set his foot on the path of Siddha Yoga after retirement. Whoever takes Diksha from Shivananda Paramahamsa are not supposed to shave their hair and the beard. If Bhagavan Nityananda were to be his disciple, then he too would stick to one rule. Can Bhagavan be bound by any rule?
Namo Nityananda.